For the life, we have with us still Dr. Omar and Dr. Hadi Abu Hantosh and Dr. Ramesh. If you have time, Alice, you can still be joining us in the live case. It will be transmitted now, if you have time. Ashraf. Yasser, احنا معاك اهو.
Hello, everyone. Thank you, Dr. Adil. First of all, I would like to thank the organizing committee and the NSHAMS team, especially Dr. Nabil Farag and Dr. Tara Rashid. The system here and the atmosphere is wonderful. I have the pleasure to introduce my dear friend and colleague, Dr. Ahmed Ifat, and Ahmed, nursing scrub, and Mahmoud, technician. We have a case today of CTO LAD and convex lesion of right coronary artery. Dr. Ahmed will present the case first.
First of all, I would like to thank and welcome Dr. Yasser Sadiq for his attendance here in our cath lab. We have a 58-year-old man. He's a smoker. He presented last May with transient infraretinal STEMI, in which he underwent primary PCI to the LCX by two drug-eluting stents. The patient had a total occlusion of LED with ambiguous stump and a total occlusion of the mid to distal right coronary, for which he was referred here for PCI to right coronary and LED.
بس بحب العيب بس حي ياسر في عين شمس واعتقد دي اول مره تبقى معانا في عين شمس صح ياسر؟
لا جيت قبل كده دكتور
لا قصدي تشتغل اشتغلت يعني؟ ورك
شوب ثانيه سيتو
اشتغلت يعني
سكند تايم
تمام 100 100 ياسر اوكي يا عم عماد كان يو كونتينيو
يس هيز ايكو شوينج اجكشن فراكشن اوف 45% with hypokinesia in the LAD territory in apex and all apical segments and akinesia in the inferior and lateral ones.
So now will Dr. Adil, do you see the angio?
Yes, yes, we can see. Okay. But in only one okay. view, it's the spider view. So
this is the first view showing that he has a patent stent of circumflex. This is the stent when he complained of chest pain when diagnosed as a STEMI. He did two stents here in this circumflex. And we revised his angio, and we found that, as you can see here, it's ambiguous stump of the LAD. Next. So this is his right coronary artery. As you can see here, he has a distal lesion of this right coronary artery, it's a co-dominant vessel. But you can appreciate here that all retrograde filling to this LAD, it's epicardial one. Next. As you can see here, all it's epicardial, straight epicardial, but nothing coming from this BDA. And you saw that we will not start epicardial. We will open this right coronary artery first, and we will get, as you can see here, next. And we will see the filling from BDA for this LAD. And this is Felder XTR for this lesion, and it passed smoothly. Next. After that, everything is clear, Dr. Adil, Dr. Amr. Everything is clear?
Yes.
Yes, yes. Tarek معانا هون كمان.
Okay. Here, I opened the right coronary artery, and I stopped here. I didn't stent this right coronary artery. Why? Because as I told you before, that all filling of this LAD, it's epicardial. And as you can see here, the lesion of the right coronary artery starting before this RV branch. So I preferred to change the wire, Felder XCR with cyan wire. Next. Here's cyan wire, and this is the right coronary artery. Next. And here, this is the dual injection to see the filling of the LED. And you can appreciate here, it's all epicardial. Next. Next. So, because this LED is ambiguous stump, and I have a clear filling from right coronary artery through straight, mini straight epicardial, I preferred to do first serving to some circles from this BDA, as you can appreciate here. This is the safest one, and this is the classic for retrograde. And after many trials for septal, I, as you can see here, next, I prefer to go epicardial and no wasting for time. Next. And now you can see here, this is epicardial collateral. Go straight to this LED, as you can see here. Next. This is a cyan black wire, and this is Caravel microcaster 150. Next. And here, the wire stopped because this is the proximal cap. So we escalating the wire to Gaia second. As Professor Khaled Tamam mentioned yesterday, the Gaia second has a power of directions excellent than the Gaia third. So I can direct the wire. As I can see here, we have ambiguous stump. Next. And here, multiple views to see, next. Where is the direction of the LED? Next. Next. Here's the exchange. The guy a second, next. As you can see here,
what do you think, Omar? Are you with us, Omar?
Yes, yes, I am with you.
Yeah, okay.
I think. Hello, Omar. How are you?
What do you think about the choice of Gaia second?
Great job so far. Sorry. Yeah. So yes, I'm really wondering what you did. So, are you here now, or you will do? You did some.
No, some progression now. I will show you. Okay.
Okay.
Next.
Great.
We can. Okay, next. So the Gaia second has some difficulty to penetrate this proximal cap. Next. But with some time, we directed the Gaia. And finally, next. This is Gaia second. Now we are in the lumen, in the aorta. As you can see here, we are in the guiding. Next. I'm here very slowly to protect the left main. And I can see here, we are in the anti-grade guiding. Next. But now I'm stopped here because the microcaster has some difficulty to go through the anti-grade guiding.
Is that Caravel?
This is Caravel, yeah. Okay, so I didn't like to get much tension on the epicardial collateral, but it's very difficult. There is no turnbike here, and so I did. Next.
Where is it stopping? At the stump or inside the?
Now I have some progression after I increase the support by anchoring balloon. Next. 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 This is the anchoring balloon. And now we are here. I will show you. We are in the beginning of the guiding caster, as you can see here. We are here now. No, that is okay. Omar, we are here now.
Okay, Yasir, good job. You know, excellent case so far. You know, it's nice that you opened RCA first. So, but I see that there is some occlusion after this retrograde wire, right? So you, I didn't see well, but I think you have to do more work from anterograde, right? Is that right? Or you already crossed all the way of the CTO?
No, after in the dual injection, we had the LED short segment, but it's ambiguous from the proximal bar. So yeah. My wire in the after coming after the CTO segment, I will show you dual injection.
Yes, dual that's injection. What I thought.
You can see here the disease ending at the site of bifurcation with diagonal here. You see?
Yes, right.
Okay. So now,
So Yasir, either to use a guiding extension, did you think about guiding extension to make it more easier or make the loop inside the LED, shorten the loop of the microcatheter?
Tariq, can you repeat, please?
Sorry, guiding extension. Can you use a guiding extension, catheter extension?
Yes, it's a very good idea, but now we had some progression after anchoring. Now our microcatheter inside the anti-grade guide.
Yes, great. That's great. Yes.
Now we'll change to RG3. Okay. RG3, please.
So now, Yasir, you are with the retrograde gear close to the distal cap. That's true,
maybe, but I will change. As Omar mentioned, the disease ending at the site of bifurcation was diagonal, and I'm sure that I am crossing the from the trulium from the non-CTO segment to CTO segment. And I will do some ballooning here, and we'll see. If I am crossing, I will use dual lumen microcatheter. No problem.
Okay.
But please, Yasir, you will show us step by step how to pull back the microcatheter from the epicardial collateral, because this is very important in avoiding complications.
Yes. Okay. Now our guiding is okay. And
Hadi is with us or no?
RG3. No. Safe floor, please.
We always call when you try epicardial collaterals, you should be in level 3 or very high level of experience. What do you think, Alison, in this respect?
Yeah, I agree. This is a very complex case, and I congratulate the operators to have done all this
Thank
work
you.
To now. So, yeah, another nowadays, I try sometimes is to perform the tipping technique in order to simplify the procedure, to switch to an anti-grade approach. Of course, this is not always possible, but it's another option that can be considered in order to simplify the procedure.
So would you spend more time searching for septal collaterals rather than using the epicardial, right?
No. Once you have performed the retrograde approach, in order to, instead of performing the
RA
session, I often perform the tipping technique. So I try to intubate the retrograde microcatheter into the anti-grade guiding with an anti-grade wire. So this is in order to switch from a retrograde to an anti-grade approach. I mean, the number of externalization I perform in retrograde approach is getting lower. because I like to use the tip-in technique.
Okay. Omar, do you have any suggestions for the pulling back of the microcaster in the epicardial vessel, or it's just as any other collateral?
Yes, mostly we like to protect epicardial epicardial collaterals with the microcatheter, especially when we remove the RG wire after we finish the work. This is so we can remove it, at the level of the collateral. Better protect collateral. I think, Adil, if you try 5 minutes for any collateral, I think you should stick to the collateral. I think 10 minutes for me is a good threshold. But you can give 10 minutes to engage it, to corrupt.
Can you tell us, Yasser, the steps you're doing now?
We did RG3 now, and now, as Tara Rashid mentioned in the first case, that we have to get the guiding caster outside, disengage from the left main and from the right coronary artery, and then we can pull back our microcaster safely. And as Omar mentioned now, we have to protect the epicardial, so I will leave my microcaster here, and now we'll do ballooning for this LED.
May I ask you to put the Anjo in full screen, please? Because
okay, ممكن نحط ال.
That's good idea. Very nice.
ممكن نحط الأنجو.
Very nice case, yes.
First you used Xeon Black and then Gaia Second, right? It was your
yes, yeah. Omar.
Yeah. Okay, very good.
Selection.
It's completely, there is a completely proximal ambiguity here.
Okay, can I ask you, Omar Lenzo, that this right coronary artery and the LED, it's a small caliber for both of them. So do you suggest to sizing with IVUS or no need for that?
Yeah, I suggest definitely IVUS.
I was for right coronary and LED, huh?
Yes, definitely.
Sometimes if you follow the anatomic rules of diameter of the right coronary being the same all over the tilt bifurcation, then I think Ivas might not be.
Yes, sir. I'd like to ask you, because I came late for the case, did you use the retrograde wire? What do you use this wire?
I used the Cyan Black over Caravel 150.
Okay.
Now we will do ballooning for this LED.
Can we see the light, please? Now we are seeing previous image. Yes, can we see live fluoro?
Fluoro?
Yeah, live fluoro, yes, that is one.
Yeah. Okay. Just to go with the missed microcaster a little bit. Okay. This is balloon for the LED. Yeah, okay. We have to ensure that we are away from the collateral.
Very, very important point.
Yes. And from
is it
to a balloon
or?
From the record. Okay, we can go now. We are away from that. Okay. You can see here there is heavy calcification of the proximal LED. Okay.
Yes.
Is that two or balloon, Yasser?
What?
Two obolon, which size?
Yes, this is two obolon, yeah.
And 20?
20. 30? 30, yeah.
It's a very long balloon, yes, 30 millimeter.
Yes.
Balloon.
Yes. As you can see here.
Very nice.
Yes.
Great.
Yes.
Very
nice.
I think you can work over this retrograde wire. No need to insert another wire into this still, I think.
You suggested to put a wire in this diagonal?
No, yeah, of course. I mean, for diagonal, yes, but I don't think we need to put another wire to distal LED because we have a nice.
Yes, it's far away, yeah?
Yes.
So now, okay. Yasser, you use a double lumen catheter?
But you don't pull the balloon until your balloon, don't pull the wire until your balloon is beyond this diagonal, right?
What?
If you are going to redirect the wire without needing a second wire, then the balloon should be below the diagonal if you're, and then pull back the wire and use it. What's your going plan? Another wire?
I will prefer to cannulate this diagonal before ballooning at the site of diagonal, because I think it's very diseased at the ostium. Sound blue, please. Sound blue. So I will, I'm trying now to put a wire in this diagonal.
Excellent point. I think we have to wire this diagonal before ballooning at that level. Otherwise, we might have easily macro dissection and we make them bigger. Very good point. And of course, we could use difficult to grow diagonal. But it's quite sizable LED. This is big LED to me now.
Yes, so, and I will get your advice that I will use IVUS before stenting. Please, same blue.
Yasser, why not to use now a double lumen catheter for getting a wire down in the LED and redirecting wire into the diagonal?
It's a good point, Tari. I will use the cyan blue assembly, and if not goes, I will use double lumen. And I'll try to offer like this.
I would do the same, actually. I would try first with wire, and if I find out it's difficult, then I have double lumen catheter. But first, I'd like to try with the wire.
And now, this is slime blue wire. Brush it in.
I think it's important to use non-hydrophilic wire here. Because
it's okay.
Yeah, very nice work.
Okay. C'est fluoro? Okay.
I guess you will do provisional stenting here, Yasser.
Yes, but I think we have to dilate this diagonal first. What do you think? I think after ballooning will disappear completely. Do you agree? What do you think, Tari? What do you think, Dr. Adil? What do you think, Omar?
If you are going to dilate the diagonal first, you have to stent the diagonal first. If you are going to do a provisional stenting, so don't dilate the diagonal now. And this is.
I 100% agree with the.
Okay, so I will get a bigger balloon to dilate this LED. Okay. And then IBUS, and then stenting. Do you agree?
Yes.
Yes. So we can تقدم انت حالتك تقدم حالتك
احنا ممكن دلوقتي ناخد بالونة
دكتور عادل ممكن نسأل بس سؤال لحضرتك وياسر وطبعا دكتور أستاذتنا لو انا ما عنديش ايفس هنا I don't have ايفس I have a very small LED with proximal LED أصغر من الأصطرحات فرأي حضرتك هنحط ستنت من البروكسيمال الأول وتبقى كام؟
you have already a sizable proximal ostial LED the LED the ostium or the LED very proximal part is at least 3.5 the IVUS will help you of course for sizing but for a proximal LED usually it's 3.5 not less than that so don't try to use smaller or diameter stents usually use the large distally with the new stents you can use the 2.5 and increase it after that I mean it's but proximally you should put a 3.5 what's your opinion Tariq
traditionally if as Yasser said he started with a 2 millimeter balloon he will upgrade balloon up to 3 millimeter he can do with a proper pre-dilatation and giving a nitro and then re-angio and assess the size of the LED. This is the maximum I can do without mm-hmm. IVUS. Mm-hmm. Of course, if you have IVUS, it would be better for assessing the size of the vessel.
Great.
It's a 3 millimeter balloon, yes, sir, or what?
This is 2.5.
You know, Omar and Alison, we have a problem with IVUS for the coast, so we don't have it in every cath lab. So we are thinking of other alternatives, what to do for sizing, and but sometimes intervention.
IVUS, guys, yalla, sorry.
You know, Adil, can you hear me?
Hadi, are you with us now?
We tried yeah, to reach I'm with you all the time, actually. I was there.
I called for you, but you didn't answer. So.
I apologize. This is really a very long segment, actually. It just the disease is not only at the bifurcation as a one type of lesion. So it's really very long. And I think, you know, the sizing is of an important issue here because this is an chronically underfilled LED, it seems like. So, and I understand this is a male, right, Adil? It's not a female.
Yes, actually, for Yasser's luck, this is the last case for life. So the best cases have been chosen before. So this is what is left, what's left for him.
So what my point, Adil, is that, you know, it will be hard to believe that this LED is less than 3.0 millimeter. And look at the area there in the middle before the bifurcation. There's a lot of calcium, I think, there.
Yeah. Yes, Dr. Hadi, you are right.
I think this LED is wrapping apical part, so it gives me that, you know, I believe proximally could be easily 4.0, you know. Before diagonal, it could reach 4.0, and after diagonal, 3.5 maybe. So I believe this is big LED.
انت ممكن تجيب الكاميرا على ايفس؟
There's some competition. We don't see it well, but after stenting, we will see better to distal. And you know, we can.
If I can make a comment, it's not about stenting, but just a comment on the technical approach. So you decide.
Leave
the retrograde. You are working on the retrograde wire.
You see the ivs now?
Yes.
No,
yes.
Not. Please show us IVUS.
You see IVUS?
Yes, we see it. Yeah. No, IVUS, no. Okay, so, I see the IVUS probe, but not the IVUS images.
Okay, this is after diagonal, as you can see here.
We can see. We are seeing only the probe, not the image. هات لنا المكنة بس بصور لنا. Oh, here. Yes, we can see it now.
Okay.
Please do it now. If they could do ring down, we see better.
Okay, I will put it now. Okay, live, please, live. Live. Here, Omar, as you can see here.
Yes. Can you do ring down, please? There is a button.
What?
Ring down. There is a button.
Ring down, please. Yeah. Ring down. Ring down. Ring down here. Yes.
It's not
record. It's not big after diagonal, I think. It's only 2.5. And now, after diagonal, it increased to 3 millimeters here. But as you can appreciate here, as Dr. Hadi mentioned, there is a lot of calcium here. You see, Omar?
Yes. Yeah.
There's a lot of calcium here. And now, it's a tapered LED. 2.5 after diagonal and 3 at the proximal part. And here, very proximal LED, it increased to up to 4 millimeters. As you can see here. So I think I have to go with NEC balloon, 3 millimeter before this diagonal. What do you think?
Good choice.
Okay.
Agree.
3 millimeter balloon, NEC, please.
معلش ياسر انا بس يعني بتهيألي ال LED بعد ال diagonal برضه مش صغير يعني at least هو يعني كان 3 ملم بعد ال diagonal or
2.5 يا طارق على الايفس
I you know to me it should be bigger than this guys you know after diagonal this LED reaching 3.0 to me I don't know
so what do you suggest to go with the balloon after diagonal By
yes.
3 millimeter? Okay.
Yeah, I think so, yes. 3 millimeter balloon.
20. بسرعة بس. إيه رأيك يا طارق? What do you suggest?
3 millimeter balloon after the diagonal, yes.
Okay. I will do it now.
Oh, by all likelihood, if you work on a good predilatation of the proximal segment where the calcium is and the area just before the diagonal, this after the diagonal segment, I'm sure it will get bigger. I'm sure it will.
Okay.
It's underfilled LED, heavy calcium, diffuse disease. So.
Good suggestion. We will start now NEC ballooning for proximal LED and then short, and then we will go after diagonal. This 3x20 millimeter NEC balloon.
Dr. Adil, please, can I ask Yasser a couple of questions, please?
Yes.
Yasser and Abdul Rahman Gamal. I want to ask you, do you need to put a wire in the distal LED? That's the first question. The second question, would you prefer to stand from proximal to distal or from distal to proximal?
It's a very good question. Omar answered the first one, that our wire of retrograde coming before the CTO segment, so we will stand on this wire. Second, okay, 20. Second question, Abdul Rahman.
He asked whether to do proximal to distal or distal to proximal.
Oh, yeah. I think I will take the decision after the Anju now.
You know, most of us, I'm sure, will agree that the best way to stand.
Before injections, can you give some natural, and we will see, you know, after nitro.
Nitro, please.
I mean, classically, all of us, I'm sure Omar and Alison and Adil agree and Tariq that we usually stent distal to proximal. But I think the major advantage of proximal stenting than distal, we learned it from the absorb time era when we used to do absorb, you know, to better size.
Right.
Remember those days.
Right.
And actually, for one of our colleagues asked if I don't have IVUS, how would I size? I think that's another trick, is that you go proximal to this. So you proximally stent, and then you try to figure out what's the best stent for the landing zone distally if you don't have IVUS.
Okay, it's really good. Yeah, I agree with you, Hadi. Yeah, so it's really good LED. What do you think? It's very nice, you know.
It's a sizable one.
Very nice one. Yeah.
So this is after NEC ballooning, 3x20 down. And I'm totally agree with Dr. Hadi that we have to stent proximally. And in CTO, usually we have remodeling after some time. So now I think it's time to stent.
So my friend, after seeing this, I would, you know, personally, I would send another wire to the distal LAD.
Okay.
Because it's the LAD, and I like to have it in my hand. If after, you know, imagine that after a dissection, if when you try to wire it, then you might have, you know, a dissection. Your wire easily could go that edge dissection. So in here, I definitely like to have one wire at the distal of the LED.
Okay, it's a good idea. I will.
Also, of course, you will remove the RG wire before stent.
Okay.
The best advantage of proximal stenting first is to properly cover the ostium of the LED without a great overlap between the stents distal and the proximal, so that you'll be sure you'll cover the ostium properly and then do the overlap downwards. This one advantage.
Which will learn from absorb, as Hayden told. Yes, I fully agree.
Yeah, that's a good point, Hayden, for sure. You know what I'm seeing, Adel, after the diagonal look down there, 15, 20 millimeters, is there a bridge there, I think? Or just, I don't know. When he takes an angio, I would like your comment, Adel and Omar and
Ayesha. I'll let Tarek say about that. The distal LAG, what do you think about it after the diagonal? Is it a healthy vessel or?
It's of course a diffusely diseased vessel, but he has to stent just immediately at the point of entry of the retrograde gear. I think this is the starting point of stent implantation. For the very distal LAD, he can do like a drug balloon or just ballooning only. It would be enough for the distal part of the LAD.
Yeah, you see that the behavior of the wire, he tried to go subintima. So we have to be very careful, you know?
Yes.
You are getting another wire now at this point.
So which wire is this?
If you want to use a wire, get a double human microcaster better, because now I think.
This is same black wire, Omar.
Oh, I don't like, you know, in here.
I will shift.
Yeah, how can easily go?
Oh, it's already on the table. So, Simon, please.
Yeah, this is very important, you know. As you know, as angio, any dissection at all, we see that it's dilated nicely. But obviously, there is micro dissection and hydrophilic easily can go, you know, into that dissection. So, yeah, I think it's important to use non-hydrophilic wire here.
Yes.
And maybe from now, you had better take a double loop catheter. But you can try first with the wire.
I will try if it.
Just try and then have a double loop catheter. Right. This is very nice work. You know, it has to be finished nicely, as you will do. But it's excellent case. I enjoy a lot myself. Very nice case from the beginning.
Thank you, Omar.
Very good. Very good.
So, Yasser, what is the point to introduce wire now? Why not to stent from the proximal now on the retrograde wire and then think but about
that? I see some dissection at the site of retrograde wire. So I want to be free to go with the stent down. It will cross the wire, Tor.
But this is real life, yes? You know, we see that very often. It happens very often. So we have to know what we do. What? Just pull back your guiding a little bit.
I think, Yasser, if you stent it only before the diagonal, then think about introducing another right. It will be much easier for you.
Okay, we'll try.
What do you think about Dr. Omar, what do you think about stenting proximally and then manipulate a second wire? Because we're not sure that all the way we are intraluminal and then, because the second wire.
It can be done, yes. He can try. I'm sure he will go. He will go. I know that he will go. Let's give him 5 minutes. He will go. But also that's a trick can be done.
Haji, what will you do, Haji?
At this point, as Omar said, I will just be patient and try to do it delicately as much as I can. I think with what he's doing a marvelous job. I think he will do it eventually. So, if I stick a stent approximately now, it's a brilliant idea, Adil. But I don't know what would happen if you cannot get into the true lumen distally afterwards. So,
yeah.
I think I need some.
That's the problem with live transmission, is that you have time constraints, and which is totally against CTO, because in CTO you have to take your time.
Of course, this is.
And this is the problem with the live transmission.
No, he is very experienced operator. I don't think he is under pressure. I don't think so.
Okay, yes. Not pressure, pressure of time, not pressure of procedure.
You see, he had a secondary.
You know, Dr. Adil, when you have your wire in the retrograde, in the anti-grade guiding, everything after that, it's easy. So most of the work, it's alhamdulillah finished, and
yes,
can go epicranial.
So. But there was a suggestion that you should put the microcaster down to the side branch and remove the wire, the RG wire, and use another wire to redirect it, and that's it. What do you think about that? This was from the attendees, from the virtual attendees, actually.
Now it's time for BMW. It's time for WM Katsura, my dear. You are still an sub intima, please.
Yes.
Now go to WM catheter, and
okay. WM catheter, please.
Please. Now you are still sub-intima, so yeah. But this is very good. We should know what we should do. Yeah. So now, even you cross now, I don't like it, Yasir, because you.
Yes. But Omar, actually, there is no here WM catheter, so I think I will go.
Let's
stand. Suggestion of Tariq, I will stand first the proximal LED.
Let's do stand. Okay.
Yes, sir. All this manipulation will lead to other section flap down to the distal LED. I think stand proximal and then rethink about the distal part of the LED at the end.
Okay.
I think this will be more wise.
Another option, leave it here and send another wire, please. Leave it there and then.
Okay. Yeah, can you get the.
60% almost.
Sign again. Sign.
Yeah.
Where sign? Sign where? Okay.
Yes, sir. Please so, save sorry, the proximal part of the LED.
You suggest to stand here at the side of the diagonal.
Yes, till the entry point of the retrograde gear. This is the part you can stand to.
Okay.
Then rethink about the distal part of the LED. It's no problem to
so
do.
So I want a vote here whether to put the stent after the diagonal and then try to manipulate the wire or before the diagonal.
Okay. So 2.75 by 38, do you agree that?
I think you'll need a longer stent. I think.
You're
going to put before the diagonal or after the diagonal, the stent?
At the side of the diagonal too.
I would rather put it after the diagonal because this is the part of the lesion.
Yes.
So if you cross after the diagonal, then the second wire will be easier to go to the true lumen. I think so. What do you think, Omar? Haji.
I think yeah, it's a good size and a good length, but I'm still wondering, what I'm seeing down the stream there, if there is a bridge, and I'll try to avoid the entry of that bridge. But otherwise, yeah, I'll take. Yeah, I think you
still have a space beyond the diagonal that you can put your stent without compromising the epicardial collateral, and then you try your manipulation. The wire will be much easier to go into the true lumen. That's what I think. رأيك يا ياسر انت؟
معلش يا دكتور عادل ما كنتش متابع حضرتك قول لي
يعني you put the stent beyond the diagonal which is the healthy part of the LAG after the occlusion and then start manipulating your wire.
Okay, I will take but this is in the true
lumen. Okay.
This is in the
fluorum.
This is the lumen from the proximal. I liked it.
Okay.
Are you injecting? Not that much, huh?
Okay. It's over this, no? Okay.
It looks like you're in the true lumen now,
yeah.
But
yes,
I want you to make an injection to be sure.
That's why.
Retrograde, of course. Huh?
Which is a good sign, yes. So the first visited diagonal. So I like that.
This is a very good example that the second wire could cross easily.
Yes.
So now, Yasser, you are going to use the anti-grade wire, yes?
I will get the injection to decide. Now together. Okay.
Great.
Okay. So now I will remove my retrograde gear to avoid stenting over this RG3 wire. Okay. RG3.
The decision now where to put your stent, the distal one, where to put it.
Yes, I will.
Because there has been now some dissection and hematoma, so.
I think what I would do, I would stand first at the proximal, then see what's going on. You know, one, I like to have it. You know, after diagonal, and then let's see.
Okay, so your suggestion, Omar, to stand proximal first.
So, Yasser, in such situation, if you don't have a double lumen catheter, do you have other solutions for getting into the true lumen away from the proximal part, getting and avoid these dissections? So just for the audience, you can advance a guiding extension over this wire, guiding extension into the mid part or till the entry point of the retrograde gear. And from this guiding extension, you can introduce another wire easily through the guiding extension into the distal LAD. So if you don't have a double lumen catheter.
It will be a double lumen.
Yes, it's a wide bore catheter.
A double lumen conduit.
Or you can use perforated balloon. That's another good trick. But the extension guiding is nice. Yeah. Easier.
Okay. Now we will check the right and the epicardial. وريني اشوف الرايت
اه بس اتقل بعدين
يلا الصوره يا عماد الصوره الرايت وري ايبي كرينيال او رايت كرينيال رايت كرينيال هنا احنا جوه
رايت اف ات از اوكي نوت
يس Sure. It's okay.
انا عايز اخش بالواير ارجع تاني ما ادزنا الو يس
You have lots of blood there. Did you deliver the baby?
اوكي شوف كان حاجه دي تمام يلا روح تاني بكلينيون احنا كده معانا ثلاث وايرات الواير ده بتاع مين لو حطيتها ثاني فين يا جماعه ملف سون اوكي يلا ويل ستنت ناو والثاني هنا اوكي بكلينيون دي نايترو نايترو جليسرين بليز وريني اشوف بس الدنيا عامله ازاي يعني وريني الجايدنج من اول
ياسر again I want to congratulate you for your efforts and because I have to leave now for another meeting and you are always welcome in عين شمس
احنا قاعدين معاك يا ياسر
it's my pleasure
احنا قاعدين معاك
ماشي. It's my pleasure and honor, Dr. Adil. This is my home. ماجستير ودكتوراه. فيعني أنا سعيد جداً بتواجدي هنا والله النهاردة. هات الاثنين 75 48.
What's your plan right here, ياسر?
I will stand by 2.75 by 48 to this LED from the proximal up to distal part and we'll see. Okay?
Okay.
You will cross. You will cross from the left main or you will stay at the
What?
You will cross over, right? From left main to LED.
I will cross over the diagonal, yes.
No, no, I mean the left main. Do you have a healthy
left
part?
Main. Yeah. I think, no, we have a stump here, Omar. Okay. Can you get Spider, please?
Sure.
The whole natural wire?
I trust you because I didn't see at the beginning well, but if you say. Better from the
Austrians. Yes, this one is.
Yeah, I think something. Just watch that Amplatz diving in the right corner. I think it's.
We have a good pressure, Dr. Hadi. We have good pressure here.
Great, great. Yeah, okay. It's just diving in. I could tell. So.
Yeah, yeah. Spider bees.
Likes to cause trouble, right, Hadi?
What's that?
You like to travel.
Oh, no, no.
Spider, 35.
I'm with you,
Yasser, don't worry. What's up, man? 35. More, what's up? Spider, what's up? 35. Yes. يلا بسرعة. Okay. You see عمر؟
Yeah, maybe. Why not come back a little bit more?
يلا ممكن نبتدي هنا.
Yes, very nice.
اطلع. 14, 16, 18, 20. روح إيبي كلينيل بعد إذنك.
So this is a 48.30, I guess, yes. Omar, he said?
2.75.
Okay.
Okay.
Which kind of stent, may I ask?
This is Zines Expedition.
Okay. See, the problem with this Expedition, I guess, you know, you can hardly go to 3.25 with it. It's not like the Sierra.
Yes.
So you have to be watchful, I guess. Wow, that looks nice, huh?
Yes. We'll get Ivas now. Okay.
Before I was, why don't you expand more proximal, and then, you know, you, I think
okay,
you need,
yes.
You need
okay.
to
make... 3.5 NEC, Agama? 3.5 NEC? Okay, what's the suggestion?
Yes. Because it's 2.75 expedition, as far as I remember, probably 3.5 is a bit big for it, for its stretch to maintain the integrity.
I think, yes, you are right, 2.75 can increase up to 3.25.
That's but exactly I think, right. I would take 3.25 and see balloon and be safe. So just.
But do you have 3 or 4? I will search. Okay, now we're waiting NEC balloon. So I think this diagonal, is small. What do you think, Dr. Hadi, Dr. Omar, Dr. Tariq, Dr. Amr, for this diagonal?
Well, Dr. Omar suggested a provisional approach, which
yes.
I think everybody would have agreed with. But I think the flow and the
can
diagonal.
Can I see the last picture, please?
Down now, yeah.
The last engine?
I think. Okay. I think we need to recross and then
after optimization of the stem.
Diagonal. I'm not happy the diagonal. It's yes. big, good diagonal.
If you can recross Yasser easily and do a PTCO only, it will be a good to preserve okay. this diagonal. Yes.
Or maybe even a dog eluting balloon after recrossing for the diagonal. Mm-hmm. That would yeah. Mm-hmm.
4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Deflate.
So which balloon is this, my friend?
This is 3.25 by 20.
Wonderful. So it's not only that he is closed by lading, it's almost like a pot now, right? For the diagonal to make it easier to access.
Yes. Okay.
It's amazing how it's going up in the cath lab, the LAD, am I right? It's already yes. going up distally.
I think I'm satisfied with the distal LED, but now I will use another wire hat to access this diagonal again. يلا. اللي كان موجود كان فيه عندنا.
Would you like
we can stent the right coronary artery.
Okay. Would you like to finish the stenting distal to the diagonal now, or you're satisfied with that already?
You want me to stent distal LED?
I don't know. Can we? If we
I will. I will IVUS it. I will IVUS after.
I see a very nice flow to distal. I would. I wouldn't to stent. You know.
Yeah.
I think it will need a stent. Yes, sir. I think.
Will better. So maybe we can call him later for a control angio. But good. I don't.
Yes.
I don't have any sure. issue.
Yeah, I'm suggesting just to have a better angio, and he said the IVUS too. So. To guide you whether you need to put another metal under the diagonal or not.
So, you'd post dilate by 2.
What that be called?
5. Yes, Yasir. 3 to 1.
3.25.
Yeah.
This proximal already, and we will IVUS it.
I'd like to see the IVUS result after that.
Yeah, okay. ممكن نروح كرينيا المدينة يلا كرينيا بيبي كرينيا عايز وير ان بعد لكم وير ان سام بلو اون This is the wire used before, so we'll get a new wire now.
Either you change the curve, or you get the one.
Oh, نفس الفكرة يعني. The same entity.
I am very happy that we have a world-class city operator in our region, really. This is very it's not easy to do on live, at least.
There are a lot of tricks you can do. Either you can exchange this microcatheter with a more supportive one. هو هنا كان مستخدم الكارافل والكارافل تيب بتاع الحقيقة بيبقى شوية البروفايل low, but it's not that supportive or strong tip to cross. You can exchange this with a Corsair Pro or a Turnpike LP. Something you can move it by rotation or not pushing only. So exchanging into a microcatheter, all you can advance wire through this guiding catheter and getting another microcatheter inside the anti-grid guide, getting this retrograde wire as a tip in into the anti-grid microcatheter. So you can do this, or you can advance wire anti-grade into the microcatheter that is coming from the retrograde side.
We have to make sure that the osteo stent is nicely opposed. I have some suspicion it's not nicely opposed to vessel.
Yeah.
Try to go substrate, and that's what I see.
Yes.
Maybe you should go bigger, because we measured that part 4-0, right? But with IVUS. So I believe we might have a little bit
Yes. هتولي 375 NC أو 4 قصيرة بس ها؟ زمان بيعمل زين؟ نايس. I think your suggestion is right, عمر. I will go to expand this proximal LED. يلا.
So Yasser, you need this wire in the circumflex. You are going to do something for the left circumflex, or only keeping it as a...
Keeping in the beginning, because I started with the opening of the right coronary artery, and I put the 7 French guiding caster in the left main. So this is called safety wire to avoid any dissection in the left main. So
now no need for this wire, as this wire keeping always the guiding oriented towards the circumflex or the crina, not yeah. toward the LED. So I prefer to remove this wire and recross by this wire into the LED. It will be much easier.
Okay.
Yasser, I have to leave now.
Okay, Omar. Nice to like see you.
Thank you very much. I'd like to congratulate you for this very nice, well done case.
Thank you, Dr. Omar. See you soon. Thank you very much for.
Thank you very much. Bye bye, guys. Thank you.
Bye.
Good to see you, Omar.
Thank you, Hadi. Bye bye.
Hello. عايزين نحطه بس هنا هات اي بي كودل تاني هو شيله خالص
دكتور طارق معلش السؤال البلونة. تاني معلش احنا يعني منتهي
خليك اي بي كودل
يلا ستنت بوست ستنت بوست
ماشي خلاص اوكي مفيش مشكله. طب ياسر احنا هنسيبك تكمل انت براحتك شويه انا بس هقول اللايف ان بوكس بسرعه كده ونرجع لك تاني تكون انت عملت الريكروسنج والكيسنج وكل ال
ستنت بوست. اوكي ماشي يا طارق.
اوكي
ستنت بوست
Well, it's of my great pleasure to introduce Dr. Tariq Rashid, طبعاً for well-known دلوقتي خلاص for CTO for a life in a box case. تفضل.
Thank you, Dr. Ahmed, dear colleagues. It's my pleasure to again share with you some experience in Cairo CTO. My case today is alive in a box. It's a complex case with double CTOs and LAD lesion. She is a female patient, 68 years old, diabetic, dyslipidemic, hypertensive, complaining of angina accelerated at for 1 month before admission to the CCU. Her echocardiography showed an ejection fraction of 45% with a segmental motion in the left circumflex and right coronary territories with moderate mitral regurgitation and ejection fair LV function. She had a scintigraphy scan showing a large infralateral defect with a low-dose dopamine echo for assessing the viability, which was positive for viability in LCX and RCA territories. And this is a coronary angiography. As you can see, this is the right coronary. It's almost occluded paraosteally and filled retrograde from the left system, mainly from the LAD, and LAD is an atherosclerotic vessel with a 70% lesion at the mid part. And also circumflex is totally occluded proximally, feeling retrograde also from the LAD. So we have a female patient diabetic with a multivessel disease and actually good targets. We have a significant mid-LAD lesion. We have double CTOs, one in the circumflex and the other in the right coronary, proximal right and proximal left circumflex. Of course, the decision here was for surgery, and this was the decision of the heart team. But this patient has a special situation that she has a daughter with a special needs, and she has to take care of her daughters, and nobody's taking care of her daughter. So CABG is not a good option for her, and we changed the decision again in the heart team for PCI, not CABG. So we have a patient with a multivessel disease, LAD significant lesion, CTO of the circumflex and CTO of the right coronary. Waiting only for the video to start.
طارق خلينا نناقش بس الانديكيشن
الاول.
دلوقتي لما يبقى في دوبتامي ستريس ايكو شوينج فيابيلتي بات نو اسكيمي with CTO
already we have we have an ischemia. We have a fixed defect also by this but we didn't assess this the defect for viability by technetium, only it's an imaging for assessing the global ischemia.
And actually many of these CTOs are done because of the quality of life and the anginal attacks, which are really significant, and you cannot even control it with optimum medical therapy. And this comes the role of CTO PCI.
Of course, and I think there is no rule for the optimum medical therapy in patient with an ejection fraction of 45% or with a preserved viability in both territories. So here the revascularization is much more important than only keeping patient on optimum medical therapy. يعني حقيقة بس هو في مشكلة عندي في الفيديو في التحميل، أنا مش عارف القصة فيها إيه.
طيب الاكسس بتاع ال سي تي او يو بريفير ترانس ريديال ولا ترانس فيمورال؟ What are your criteria to
this is according to the situation in a complex, very complex CTO with a high G CTO score, I prefer the femoral approach for better support and getting a wider bore guiding catheters. Sometimes 8 French guiding catheter is needed. In those with simple or not difficult CTOs, I prefer to go through arm approach, mainly maybe bilateral radial, and nowadays I am going on same arm approach. This is radial ulnar approach. I can go for this. And sometimes 7 French in one of them is okay. 7 French in radial and 6 French in ulnar, this is can work. And already I have a series of cases, at least 35 cases I did with the same arm approach.
No single complication, the radial or ulnar?
Yes, no single complication, till now.
Or from the left you can go with the distal radial, and from the right you can go just the right radial, the regular right radial, and,
yes,
and that would also be a possibility.
من غير ما تعمل اي تيست يا طارق ها
سوري
من غير اي تيست للراديال اور النر يو كان جو فور بوث
من غير اي تيست
يعني
بتشيك بس ان ان هم فعلا اوكي يعني
اوكي
You remember how many cases where you used the same arm radial and ulnar?
Yes, I said 35 cases now.
35 cases to date. Thank you.
And I have 3 of them are females. You know, females have almost smaller vessels. Yes, but 3 of the 35 are females. أو في مشكلة في الفيديو الحقيقة.
But would you recommend for anybody to do the same thing, or would you stay still that this has been a long experience curve until you use both arteries in the same arm?
Of course, you have to be a little bit more experienced so as not to have a long time procedure in the same arm, and this the main problem of this approach is the arm pain. It's a common symptom. Almost all of them have arm pain after this.
Especially
this
with putting
yes.
two guiding catheters in the same brachial and axillary. I mean, it's at times you get more spasms and so on. So, yeah.
معلش انا يعني الحقيقه يعني هخليها بقى مش فيديو هخليها كيس عاديه احنا يعني الابروتش بتاعنا هنا وي هاف ال اي دي سيجنيفيكانت ليجن اند دبل سي تي اوز يوزوالي ماي ابروتش توردز اني كيس وذ مالتي فيسل ديزيز اور مالتيبل سي تي اوز اور ال اي دي افكشن اي ستارت فيرست وذ ال اي دي ايذر ال اي دي از ا سي تي او اور نون سي تي او سو First, you have to start with the most important vessel. And the most important vessel, of course, is the left anterior descending. So, started by doing a PTCA, then stenting of the mid part of the LAD with a drug-eluting stent. And this is a 3.5 by 32 millimeter stent for the LAD, and then doing a post-dilatation with a 4 millimeter balloon. So here, in a multi-vessel disease, double CTOs, LAD, first start with the left anterior descending. حقيقة الابروتش ده مهم جدا ان انت يبقى عندك ال LAD working nicely, هي support circulation, هيبقى procedure less risky than if you have a problem in the LAD itself. Then, after doing this, LAD, we shifted to the left circumflex. And this lesion of the circumflex is a moderate complexity lesion with some calcification and a blunt stump. blunt proximal stump. In such moderate complexity lesion, الحقيقة يعني مش لازم بقى نقعد نبتدي بويرات مش هتبقى ذات effective, يعني مش لازم الفيلدر اكس تي, لان هنا الليجن ده محتاج penetration force عالية شوية ومحتاج control شوية within the lesion, وهيبقى عندي calcification محتاجين to penetrate. ثانيا نحن عندنا distal bifurcation. distal bifurcation الحقيقة في polymeric wires مش هيبقى لطيف قوي, لان عادة polymeric wires بتجو easily into the subintimal space. فعشان كده احنا اخترنا intermediate stiffness wire, واخترنا الواير ده اللي هو كان الجايا ثير. الجايا ثير طبعا هو الهايست بنتريشن في الجايا فاميلي, هو 4.5 جرامز وتيبرد لغاية 0.12 او 12. ليه هنا خدنا كورسير مايكرو كاتيتر؟ الحقيقة عشان انا محتاج سبورت كويس, لان انا معدي في كالسيفايد ليجن, فالكورسير برو هتبقى هتديني سبورت اكتر وهقدر اعدي بيها مش بالبوشابيليتي بس, لان الحقيقه البوشابل مايكرو كاتيتر كل ما هتزق كل ما هيخلي الجايدنج ترجع لورا, مش هيبقى عندك جود سبورت. خاصه ان انا هنا ما كانش عندي الحقيقه ان اكسلنت سبورت, يعني الليفت مين از نوت ذات لونج, والجايدنج كاتيتر كانت جوينج باك اولموست اولويز واحنا بنادفانس المايكرو كاتيتر. ف الكورسير برو هي الحقيقه جود تشويس ان ساتش كيس. هنا ده دياجرام بس سريعا كده ازاي هنعمل مانيبيليشن للجايا واير. والجايا واير زي ما قلنا هو محتاج سبيشال كنترول, مش محتاج ان احنا نعمل رابيد روتيشن, محتاج سبيشال ديديكيتد تكنيك اللي هو الديفليكشن تكنيك, جاست مينيمال بوشنج اند روتيشن ان ليميتد دايركشن ويذين 90 ديجريز ماكسيمم, اند ذن بوشنج اند ريدايركت ذا واير اف يو هاف ذا باكل ات ذا تيب اوف ذا واير, جيت ذا واير باك اند ريدايركت ذا واير ان ذا اوبوزيت دايركشن اند ادفانس. And you have to control this wire well to navigate the total occlusion, and this is the way we have we use this wire. So after crossing by the microcatheter, we exchange this guy wire into our coarse wire, then advancing a balloon and doing a PTCA, and stenting with a 3.538 millimeter drug eluting stent again, and doing a post dilatation with a 3.5 NC balloon, and this is the final result of the left circumflex. So here we have to go for the right coronary. Actually right coronary we don't have a good area for to get anti-grade, and we don't have a good support. It's a paraosseal occlusion, and here we have a good collateral supply, although it's a tortuous collateral, but it's a good collateral supply. عشان كده الحقيقة احنا ابتدينا نختار الكولاترال ده, هو very tortuous, ده regular sine wire, وعلى regular sine wire ده برضو خدنا ال Corsair Pro micro catheter. الحقيقة هو يعني الواير ده sorry collateral ده septal, بس it's a very tortuous collateral. So you have to use a soft wire in this tortuous septal collateral. Sine wire is a soft wire. It's a 0.7 grams deep load spring coil wire. And don't push this wire vigorously. Wait for the heartbeats and for the movement of the heart. Take this wire into the through the collateral to the occluded vessel. هنا احنا الحقيقة بنصبر شوية على الواير لغاية ما يبتدي ياخد البوزيشن بتاعه. To advance the microcatheter first, then wait for the wire برضو تاني لغاية ما يبتدي يعدي لوب, وبعدين ما ادفانس تاني المايكرو كاتيتر وتسيبه شوية لغاية ما يبتدي يعدي اللوبس واحدة واحدة. ما فيش داعي للزق قوي في التورشوستي دي, عشان الزق في التورشوس كولاترالز بيعمل انجري, بيعمل سيبتال هيماتومز, وهتخسر كولاترال الحقيقة هو جود كولاترال going to the opposite side. طيب بعد ما عدينا خلاص بالمايكرو كاتيتر ده, الحقيقه ميزه الفرق ما بين البوشنج والتورك, البوشنج والروتيشن في المايكرو كاتيتر ده ممكن يزود الفورس يعني اب تو 12 تايمز او 13 تايمز, في بدل ما تعمل بوشنج بس, لا تعمل بوشنج اند روتيشن, بيزود الفورس بتاع الموفمنت بتاع المايكرو كاتيتر الحقيقه اكتر من 10 مرات. ف this is very important. دي فروق بسيطة كده ما بين الكورسير برو والكورسير القديمة. الكورسير برو الحقيقة كان فيها ديستال ماركر, الماركر ده كان بيقلل التراكابيليتي شوية بتاعة المايكرو كاتيتر, وبيخليها تبقى شوية الكروسابيليتي ديفيكولت في الـ ده الماركر اللي كان موجود في الكورسير العادية, ده اتلغى في الكورسير برو, والموست الفيزيبيليتي واحدة ما فرقتش كتير, بس الماركر ده فرق كتير جدا في انه خلى التيب مور فليكسبل, فتعدي البنز بطريقة اسهل. ده حاجة كده سريعة بتبين ازاي الفرق ما بينهم. دي الكورسير العادية زي ما انت شايف الديمونستريشن ده بيوضح فرق الفلكسبيليتي بتاعت التيب بتاع الكورسير برو من الكورسير العادية. فديس از وان اوف ذا ادفانتجز اوف ذا كورسير برو مايكرو كاتيترز. طبعا الكورسير برو اكس اس مور يعني تراكابل بيكوز اوف ذا لو بروفايل اوف ذا مايكرو كاتيتر. حاجه تانية هنا في سبايرال كونكشن موجود في اخر المايكرو كاتيتر. السبايرال كونكشن ده الحقيقه قلل الكينكس اللي بتحصل مع الروتيشن واليوز بتاع المايكرو كاتيتر، فبالتالي ده حسن شويه الـ 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 الاداء بتاع المايكرو كاتيتر نفسها. هنا بعد ما احنا كروست بالمايكرو كاتيتر الكورسير وبقينا موجودين في الفيسل ريتروجريد، ابتدينا تو كروس بالجايا واير وعدينا فعلا بالجايا واير، وكان عندنا مشكله هنا في جيتنج الواير انتو ذا جايدنج كاتيتر. زي ما شفنا الحاله بتاعت امبارح احنا عندنا طريقه تانية ان احنا ممكن تسنير الواير ده ونبتدي نشتغل، بس هنا الحقيقه ادينا شويه وقت، يعني خدنا حوالي 10 دقائق لغايه ما قدرنا ندخل الواير ده جوه الجايدنج كاتيتر. احنا هنا خدنا واير سوفت تاني، خدنا الساين مره تانية عشان نقدر تو كنترول الواير وندخله جوه الجايدنج كاتيتر. وبعدين بعد كده زي ما احنا شايفين احنا هنا نافخين بالونه في الجايدنج كاتيتر دي، زنقنا الواير ده جوه الجايدنج كاتيتر. اما بتزنق الواير ده يبقى انت كده عندك الواير تقدر لو شديت عليه من الناحيه الثانيه المايكرو كاتيتر تعدي بسهوله تو كروس الليجن ده انتو ذا انتي جريد جايد. فعملنا ترابنج وبعدين عملنا بي تي سي اي، ذن افتر دوينج بي تي سي اي ستنت تو ذا بروكسيمال رايت كوروناري ستنت three millimeter 3x38 millimeter stent. وبعدين عملنا بالون للديستال بارت بتاع ال LED، وده كان الفاينل ريزلت بتاعت الديستال بارت بتاعت الرايت كوروناري سوري، وده الفاينل ريزلت بتاعت الرايت كوروناري. اند اتس اوف كورس ا دومينانت فيسل اند اي ثينك اتس ا جود ريزلت. طبعا قبل ما بنسحب الواير زي ما اتفقنا من جوه الكولاترال خاصه ده تورسوس كولاترال يو هاف تو تشيك باي انجيوجرافي ان الكولاترال ده ما حصلش فيه اي انجري، ولازم تو كيب واير انسايد الفيسل. يعني الواير ده ما اقدرش اسحبه من جوه الكولاترال الا ما اطمن ان خلاص الكولاترال كله تمام، انا سحبت المايكرو كاتيتر لورا عشان طول ما المايكرو كاتيتر جوه الكولاترال وانت هتشيك حقيقه وجود المايكرو كاتيتر بيسد الكولاترال خالص، فلازم تسحبها بره الكولاترال وتحقن عشان تطمن ان مفيش اي انجري في الكولاترال. اطمننا كده نقدر نسحب الواير براحتنا عادي مفيش مشكله. وديس از ذا فاينل انجيوجرام.
ثانك يو فيري ماتش طارق، الحقيقه اكسلنت ديمونستريشن. اني كويستشن فور طارق؟
Very nice case, case story. And first of all, I would like to thank you, Tarek, for this effort with us today and yesterday. And very nice cases that you gave us yesterday and help today for everyone. And I'm very happy, definitely. This is the first time to work in Shams University, but I feel that I'm in Cairo University, the same feeling, the same atmosphere. I asked Tarek that to be repeated again, inshallah, and we can share together everything.
Of course, it's your home, Dr. Amr. It's our pleasure to have you in Ain Shams, and we are grateful for this. Always with us, doing a conferences and meeting with Cairo CTO, and I think it's a good conference الحقيقة. يعني من الحاجات الواحد القليلة الواحد شاف فيها يعني شغل محترم يعني على مدار اليومين، محاضرات جميلة، يعني تنظيم أكثر من رائع. الحقيقة أنا بشكرك جدا دكتور عمرو ودكتور عادل على المجهود العظيم اللي أنتوا عملتوه، وشكرا لكل الحضور الحقيقة برضو على تواجدكم لغاية آخر لحظة. يعني شكرا جزيلا.
سؤالي دكتور طارق، معلش.
بشكر برضو دكتور نبيل فرج، يعني عامل كان معانا سبورت جامد، ودكتور أشرف بدوي طبعاً على رأسهم.
عمر هنرجع لللايف بس شوية وبعدين.
طيب ماشي، بس نشكر في أشرف الأول وآيريس عشان بصراحة.
أخبار يا ياسر؟
تمام أنا خلصت يا طارق، بس عايز أوريك الدياجونال كده.
إيه أخباره؟
أرجع تاني، أنا خلصت بستنت الرايت كوروناري دلوقتي.
أنا شايف في حاجة ملونة في الرايت كده تحت يا ياسر، ده يعني ده ستيننج ده ولا إيه؟
ده الديستريكشن بتاع الرايت ما انا عشان عملنا بالونينج هنا وبقالنا شويه بنحن بس شايف هات بس الاول هات ارجع ده الرايت ارجع
حطيت ستنت ها
انا حطيت ستنت في بروكسمال للال ده النت ريزلت بتاع الال دي والدياجونال وانا عملت ايفس الدياجونال الال دي كويس هو الدايمتر تحت الدعامه حوالي 2.5 مفيش اي ديستريكشن في الاب ولا حاجه بعد الستنت والستنت والابوزد الحته اللي عند اللي فوق الدياجونال على طول دي هيفلي كالسيفيك والحقيقه انا يعني مش عايز اعمل لكن الستنت والابوزد بس الحته دي فيها كالسيوم كتير والحقيقه مش عايز اخد فيها ان سي اكتر من كده انا خدت فيها اب تو 3.75 عشان تو افويد اني بيرفوريشن والدياجونال عملنا له هات الصوره لاب عملنا كيسنج الصوره لاب اهو قبل عملنا كيسنج هات بقى بعد ودي الصوره بعد الكيسنج
I think yesterday you got the good flow for the LED and the diagonal and the RC. So I think.
Yes, I. Tariq, what do you think, Dr. Amr? I will stop. دل صورة الايبس. هات آخر صورة. آخر صورة اللي هي right.
Just you don't have a dissection in the osseous diagonal, yes, or you have a dissection? I can't see. This is a branch or dissection.
We have. لا هات آخر صورة ال LED. ارجع تاني. عندنا dissection أو في الأوستيال LED في الأوستيال diagonal يا طارق. But I think in Nana, I have to stop here. This diagonal is very small. You can see here, it's less than 2 millimeters. So I will not stent this diagonal. What do you think?
Yeah, in a fiddle section, I think put a 2.25 stent so as not to root this diagonal.
Because you do a lot of effort, yes, sir, to open this diagonal. And
I agree it's a small, yes, Dr. Amr, but yeah. It's like the distal LED.
I think, as you mentioned, Tariq, we can use a stent for this diagonal.
Are you a stent?
You know, I'm can you hear me?
Hadi, how are you?
Oh.
We hear you.
دلوقتي أنا stented the right.
Dr. Hadi.
بس congratulations يا عم والله 2 days very successful very fruitful congratulations ليك والدكتور عادل وكل البورد
we need only a 20 millimeter contrast extra yeah it's not
thank you Dr. Hedge
so to keep it open for a long time or long term
تعرف ياسر انت في الصورة كان الدياجونال الاوستيوم مش واضح انه في اي dissection يظهر ان في برانش كده دانسينج باك اند فورث بيديك كده فولس امبريشن انه في دايسكشن لو تورينا انجو كده يكون واضح ذا ويل بي فيري نايس
طب رايك ايه يا دكتور هادي في ال يو دو يو ثينك يو نيد تو بوت ا ستنت او نو
Well, يعني it's a very small artery. I think if it has a good flow without a nasty dissection proximal, I will be hesitant actually. But
Dr. Hadi, I would like to second your opinion, and I think this diagonal can be left as such. And it's not a very large vessel. 2.25 is rather small, and the instantary stenosis at that point would be considerable. So I think the LED looks good, and the RCA is not is good at all. So I think with an LED and RCA, things look very good without stenting the diagonal.
Thank you, Dr. Khaled. I think I would prefer to leave this diagonal like that because it's 2.25 okay. Stenting, and the stent of LED 2.75, the risk stenosis rate will be high.
Dr. Mohammed Hilmi, عايز أسألك يا
سيدي. أنا مع نفس الرأي اللي هو don't stent الداج. ده هي بالرونج بروسيدور جدا واللي عايز واخد ضاي كتيرة طبعا واضح. دي نمرة واحد نمرة اثنين
لا ما خدناش
ممكن يحصل رومبس في الال اي دي لان ممكن مع الستنتنج بتاع الداج يحصل رومباي بتاعته تضيع لنا الدنيا كلها خالص هو سمول مش مدي اريا كبيره في الاداب دي كلها انا مش مع ان الستنت الداج في برضه بحكمه ان احنا
ما بس الحكمه في برضه ذيس از رايت بس احنا طارق وبرضه وانا رايي And no, and this is the only diagonal that was given by this LED, and you open the LED, and the LED is diffusely diseased distal. So this diagonal is important for even with a small size. I know,
of course,
it's a significant.
Factor. And also, stenosis or long-term occlusion is better than the abrupt occlusion. So
quick angiogram,
the risk of acute occlusion of this diagonal is very high with this last section. But keeping a stent, keep this diagonal patent, and even if there is stenosis later on, nothing. Okay. To be a chronic process, not an acute occlusion.
So,
we don't know. This section might cause an acute occlusion.
Dr. Hadi, what do you think?
It's of course a dissection flap.
Yeah.
It's a dissection flap.
What do you think? Dr. Hadi, what do you think?
I think there is a non-obstructive plaque, dissection there. It's going up. Can you show us the rest of the diagonal? I'm sorry.
You can't guarantee, Dr. Hadi, the time of this abrupt occlusion. When? So now we are giving heparin.
The first diagonal has an ostial disease also.
There is a dissection there.
Yeah, it's a long disease. Yeah,
I think 2.25, a short stent will be good.
This is Dr. Amr, Dr. Tariq, Dr. Hadi, Dr. Khalid. This is a very small diagonal. It's a very small.
Okay.
So Yasser, this diagonal is coming out from a stent, and if you have an abrupt occlusion of this diagonal at this part, it will be a very dangerous, also endangering the stent, of course, in the LED, not only the diagonal. So I think keeping this diagonal open, avoiding an acute occlusion.
You don't want to use a stent, Yasser, because of the small only, or just you want to jeopardize this LED?
No, it's a small.
Okay,
I think
if you want to be sure, you can do IVUS if you want.
Unfortunately, this is a high-grade dissection type. It's unfortunate.
Yeah.
It looks like an interluminal filling defect. Those don't stay open for long, and it might abruptly close. I think putting a 2.25 short to 12 stent only, just so that you don't land on the small portion of the diagonal, would not be a bad option.
I think the clinical situation of the patient itself.
2.5 أو 13. في 2.5 13 2.5. دي 2.4 عايز 2.5.
Stent, ماشي.
Okay. So, as you all encouraged me to put a stent, I will do it.
I hope it will go well, because we don't want to encourage you to spoil the fun. You've been doing a marvelous job, الحقيقة. تهانينا إلك والله.
Thank you, Dr. Hadi. Thank you. هات بقى الـ MC طيب الـ MC اللي هي 3.25 يلا هات
Maybe in another scenario we can leave this diagonal. So I think but this now is important.
Dr. Amr, I think it depends on the patient itself. If there is no chest pain, no hemodynamics, we can leave it. يعني انما العيال بيقي في الداج اكشولي يعني اكيوتلي بيبقى عنده شيست بين عنده هيمودينامكس انما لو العيال تيمتو وما عندوش شيست بين وهيمودينامكس كويس ما قربش بقى
نو شيست بين يا
دكتور محمد I'm totally respecting what you mentioned but this is a CTO case and when we have such as a diagonal and I did a lot of effort to reach this diagonal and I have some fear after get wire out, this diagonal will close. I will be sad. Okay. So now I will stent it as Dr. Hadi mentioned, very small stent, and I think from my little experience, the two stent technique in the LED and diagonal get long term results better than OCL LED or okay هنحتاج دعامة جديدة وديني سواء هنحتاج بالونة 3.5
وهات لي دعمل دلعتها. اوكي يلا The surprise for me is that this right coronary artery is too big, not as small as it appeared in the first angio. Now we stented the mid right coronary artery by 275, and the IFAS getting pictures that this right coronary artery, it's more than 3 millimeters. So I will do NEC after stenting the diagonal now.
Okay. We have 5 minutes, yes, sir, so.
Okay, I finished. You will see stent of the diagonal and the end result, and you can go.
Oh, it's a very nice case, yes, sir, and the very good work with all the team. I think that this very nice case to do how to deal with this long lesions and
again, before you go, Dr. Amr, I want to thank you and Dr. Adel Atrebi for the excellent organization. I want to thank Incham's department, my dear home. Really, here the atmosphere is very good. I have an excellent operators beside me today, Dr. Imad and Dr. Mustafa. And all the team of Incham's marvelous Hayya. I enjoyed working here today, and thank you, Tariq Rashid, for making this happen with your department. Thank you, Dr. Nabil, for great support and this a lot of effort today. When one working in CTO, he realized that everything is here. This is a personal experience. It's a very good job. Yalla.
Thank
Yalla.
You, yes, sir. We hope to be next year from all the department in all over Egypt. So very nice. Now I have a test.
It's okay. Yalla. انت لعب دعم الأول. دعم. اطلع 2-4. حاضر.
It's okay.
انت بتطلع بالدعمة؟ اطلع 6-8-10-12-14-16-18
It's okay.
هنعمل بقى هنا يلا كيسينج.
You will now kiss?
Yes, يلا.
Okay.
2-4
We need the picture after you finish.
12-14
Very nice kiss. So just we need a picture.
Diagonal feet. This is okay. And bot, yalla, itla, itla, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, deflate. The patient here want to thank Dr. Nabil and Dr. Tariq.
ونبي سلم لي عليه عشان شفته مبارح وأجلنا النهاردة معلش قول له معلش.
دكتور عمرو بيسلم عليك وكمان.
هو كله هرب منه امبارح يا ياسر يعني
لا بصراحه دي كانت الحاله
يعني.
بصراحه دي الحاله اللي كنت هعملها الحمد لله ان انا ما عملتهاش امبارح يعني بصراحه دي كانت اول حاله هتتعمل بس طلع لي حاله كده عملتها الحمد لله برضو
لا يعني حقيقه فيري نايس جوب يعني اكسلنت ياسر تسلم ايدك شغل الحقيقه رائع وحاجه يعني
عايزين صوره بقى يعني. عايزين صوره
حاضر
As usual, Dr. Yasser, you are very gifted and wonderful in how you manipulate your equipment, and you did a very good job. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Khaled. Thank you.
So you will now finish the right?
الحقيقة أنا عاوز to compliment Yasser على how cool, how quiet he is, and how focused he is. Congratulations, والله Yasser. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
One test.
Okay. الصورة. Okay.
Very big diagonal. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes. So I am very happy to be at the end of this number of attendees. Thank you, Iris, for this great meeting. And I hope next year will be very bigger than this one.